Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Earlier this morning or yesterday, depending on your time zone, SpaceX's 66th mission of the year launched successfully with Starlink 617. The booster which launched this mission, B1060, then became the first booster to successfully land for the 17th time on the drone ship A Shortfall of Gravitas. Coming up later in the week and into next week, we can hopefully expect to see a couple more Starlink launches. The next of these, the Starlink 618 mission, is currently scheduled for Sunday 24th at 12:06 a.m. UTC or Saturday 23rd at 8:06 p.m. EDT. Then, a little over a day later, we could see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 73 mission is currently scheduled for Monday 25th at 7:11 a.m. UTC or 3:11 a.m. EDT. There were recently some issues from the government regarding SpaceX's hiring practices. There was an article posted about SpaceX fighting a lawsuit with a lawsuit of its own. It says SpaceX has responded to a Justice Department lawsuit about the company's hiring practices with a suit of its own, arguing that the government's case is unconstitutional. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the launch site. After tearing up some concrete under the orbital launch mount, some new concrete was seen being poured. Work continues on Mega Bay 2 in the production yard. Here's a look at a mystery structure that's been spotted lately. You can see here that where the old mid-bay was, there's a load of groundwork going on for the Star Factory expansion. Here you can also see how they are progressing with the Star Factory expansion. There was an article posted with information from the FAA on when they may wrap up their safety reviews and issue a launch license. It says the head of the Federal Aviation Administration's Commercial Space Transportation Office says he believes that the FAA can wrap up safety reviews needed to update the SpaceX Starship launch license by the end of October, but then a concurrent environmental review is a wild card to that schedule. Recently, Ship 25 was destacked from Booster 9 to receive its flight termination system explosives. Crews are working to prepare Ship 26 for some testing as it sits on the Pad B test mount. Starship 31 was seen continuing to be stacked inside the high bay. Booster 10 underwent some cryo testing recently at Massey's. Here's some more Booster 13 stacking seen going on in the Mega Bay recently. As always, I have to say thanks to Sean Doherty for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.